In the last lecture, we made an introduction to weaker routing and scheduling problems in the service operations, and we talked about the common and differentiating characteristics of different weaker routing and scheduling problems. In this lecture, we will see traveling salesman problem, in short TSP, and weaker routing problem, in short VRP, and we will develop mathematical models and learn simple heuristics to solve these problems. Let me start with TSP, which is one of the most studied problems in management science. In TSP, there is a single vehicle that originates from a single depot. The vehicle has no capacity restriction. There are a number of customer nodes to be visited, and customers may be visited in any order. There are no precedence relationships between these customers, and there are no delivery time restrictions for the customers. The output, that means the solution for a TSP instance, is a route or a tour where each node is visited exactly once, and the route begins and ends at the depot node. The tour is formed with the goal of minimizing the total tour cost. This cost may be due to traveling time or traveling distance or any other cost metric can be used. Generally, we define traveling salesman problem on a complete network. By complete network, we mean that there is an arc between each pair of nodes in the network, as you see here. For a complete network where we have an arc between each pair of nodes, there are n minus 1 factorial feasible solutions for a TSP instance having n nodes. Therefore, as the number of nodes gets larger, the solution space gets larger. As I told before, the graph, that means the complete graph, can be directed or indirected. The TSP defined on a directed graph is called as asymmetric TSP, and the TSP defined on an undirected graph is called as symmetric TSP. As I told before, TSP is one of the most studied problems in management science, and there are approaches to solve traveling salesman problem to optimality. But in reality, most of the TSP instances are not solved to optimality within a tolerable time limit, as the problem is an NP-hard problem. The largest TSP instance that is solved to optimality includes 24,978 cities. However, we require that much time in order to solve this instance to optimality. To solve small size TSP instances to optimality, we can use exact approaches. And these approaches might be based on mixed integer programming, that means mathematical formulations, branch and bound or branch and cut procedures. And we will see mixed integer programming formulation during this lecture. In addition, if the problem size is large, in order to obtain a solution quickly, a good solution quickly, we generally use heuristic approaches. These approaches can be classified as constructive heuristics, improvement heuristics, and meta-heuristic approaches. When do we prefer heuristic approaches instead of exact approaches? When the problem size is large and we want to obtain a solution, a good solution quickly, then we use heuristic approaches. In addition, if we are using approximate values for problem parameters, which means that we can never be sure about the optimality of the resulting solution, then it is better to use heuristic algorithms, okay? Okay, let me start with developing a mathematical formulation for the traveling salesman problem. As I told before, we generally define a TSP instance on a complete graph. If the original graph is not complete, then what should we do? Then we can solve all pair shortest path problem for the graph and obtain the distance, time, or cost between each pair of nodes so that we can transfer the original graph to a complete graph, okay? And after obtaining a complete graph, suppose that Cij denotes the traveling cost associated with arc ij. And in this problem, we want to determine the sequence of nodes to be visited. Therefore, we can define our decision variable as xij, where this is a binary variable, and it is 1 if edge ij is in the solution, it means that xij is 1 if node j is visited immediately after node I in the solution, it is 0 otherwise. In traveling salesman problem, our objective is minimization of total cost, traveling cost. So our objective is to minimize z, which is equal to the summation of cij multiplied by xij for all arcs in the network. We want to obtain such a solution at the end for a complete graph of the corresponding nodes. Okay, what are the constraints for a model that can solve traveling salesman problem? From this feasible solution, we can understand that for each node, there is exactly one incoming arc in the solution, and there is exactly one outgoing arc in the solution. So we should represent it as a constraint in the model. How can we represent this? For any node in the node set, that means we should have xij summed over j for outgoing arcs, okay, summed over j, where j is in v, should be 1, okay? However, this set shouldn't contain I, right? Otherwise, we will allow self loops. Similarly, there should be exactly one incoming arc in the solution for each node of the network. Is this model sufficient to represent a traveling salesman problem, to solve a traveling salesman problem instance? We can have such sub-tours, right? For if we have an 8-node TSP instance, as you see here, if we have just these two constraints, then we allow such sub-tours because, as you see here, for each node, we have just one incoming arc and just one outgoing arc. Therefore, by using just these two constraints, we cannot eliminate sub-tours. How can we eliminate sub-tours? There are two ways of eliminating sub-tours. Let me write one of them here and the second one here. How can we eliminate sub-tours? Actually, these sub-tours can exist for any subset of the nodes, okay? So we should write a constraint for any possible subset of the nodes. If we observe these sub-tours, we see that there is no outgoing arc from this sub-tour, right, in the solution. For instance, for this sub-tour, there is no outgoing arc in the solution. Similarly, for this sub-tour, there is no outgoing or incoming arc to this sub-tour. In the first alternative way, we will try to eliminate this. First of all, we should write this constraint for every subset of V, but for the subset that is equal to V, this constraint shouldn't be valid. As another point, we shouldn't consider the subset that has size 1, okay? Xij summed over I coming from S and J coming from V minus S should be greater than or equal to 1. Is it clear? By this way, we ensure that there should be one outgoing arc from this subset, okay, to the outside of the subset. This is one of the alternative ways that can express sub-tour elimination. Another way is that it is based on another observation. Okay, if we look at this subset, how many xijs are one? We have exactly 4 arcs, xij 1, right? If we sum xijs over this subset, then we will get 4. And for this subset, it is 3. For this subset, it is 2. Xij summed over S should be less than or equal to the cardinality of the subset minus 1. For, again, all subsets, but I exclude the set itself and also this should be valid for all subsets that have a cardinality greater than 1. Okay, we can use any one of these alternative subtour elimination constraints in order to eliminate subtours. However, as you can understand, the number of subtour elimination constraints for an instance having n mod, 2 to the power n minus 1, since I exclude v, and minus n, right? Actually, we have exponential number of subtour elimination constraints. Okay? So by using this mathematical model, we cannot solve traveling salesman problem to optimality within a polynomial time, because in order to generate subtour elimination constraints, I require exponential time. As a result, we obtain this MIP formulation for TSP problem. The first constraint ensures that there is exactly one outgoing arc in the solution for each node. And the second constraint ensures that there is exactly one incoming arc for each node in the solution. The fourth or fifth constraint eliminates subtours. And we know that Xijs should be binary for all arcs. In this lecture, we will learn two commonly used heuristics for traveling salesman problem. These are the nearest neighbor procedure and the Clark and Wright savings heuristic. Let me start with the nearest neighbor procedure. The nearest neighbor procedure builds a tour based only on the cost or distance of traveling from the last visited node to the closest node in the network. Therefore, the heuristic is simple, but it has the disadvantage of being rather short-sighted, that means myopic, as we will see in the next example. Let me first outline the procedure. It starts with a beginning node, that means the depot node that the vehicle originates from. Then it finds the closest node to the last added node, which is initially depot node. And then it repeats the second step until all nodes are visited. That means all nodes are added to the tour. And it finishes the route by connecting the first and the last visited nodes. Okay, we can apply this procedure on a simple example. In this example, we have a 6-node TSP instance. The traveling distance matrix for the problem is provided in this table. As the distance from any node I to any node J is the same as the distance from node J to node I, we can say that this TSP instance is a symmetric TSP instance, okay? Because as you see here, the traveling distance matrix is symmetric. Suppose that node 1 is the depot node, so the vehicle should start its tour from that node, and we will apply nearest neighbor heuristic to this instance. Okay, what is the closest node to node 1? It is node 3, right? So after visiting node 1, the vehicle should visit node 3. And then in the second step, we find the closest node to the last node added, which is 3. What is that? It is 6. Actually, it is 1, but we have already visited node 1. And after 6, we add the closest unvisited node to the tour. What is that? It is 2. And after that, the closest unvisited node is node 5, and after that, the closest unvisited node is node 4. And then, since we have visited all nodes, we should return back to depot. If you compute the length of this tour, you will see that it is 35.4 miles. But is this the best possible route for this example? For example, let's consider this tour, 1, 2, 5, 4, 3, 6, 1. Its total distance is 30.9 miles, which is better than this, right? So we can see that nearest neighbor algorithm cannot guarantee optimality for all instances. For this small network, it can be possible to enumerate every possible tour. However, for large problem sizes, where we have 100 to 200 nodes, enumerating every combination would be impossible. So we generally use other heuristic approaches. Before leaving the nearest neighbor heuristic, it should be noted that in practice, the heuristic is applied repeatedly by assigning every node to be the depot node and resolving the problem and then selecting the lowest cost tour as the final solution, okay? In this example, recall that we selected node 1 as the depot node. In the next step, we can select node 2 as the depot node and apply the procedure and then find a solution. In the upcoming steps, we can select other nodes as well as the starting node and then select the best solution among all these solutions. The second heuristic for traveling salesman problem is Clark and Wright savings heuristic. It is one of the most well-known techniques for solving traveling salesman problems. The aim of this heuristic is to schedule vehicles operating from a central depot and serving several outlying points, that means customers. It is applied to the problem instance through a series of iterations, that means it's an iterative approach, until we find a feasible solution. The logic of this algorithm involves a savings concept, and this concept is extremely important because we use this savings concept in different heuristic algorithms. And this savings concept considers the savings that can be realized by linking pairs of delivery points, that means customer nodes, in a system that is composed of a central depot serving the customer node. Okay, we will see an example next. Suppose that we have two customer nodes and we have one depot node, as you see here. The customer nodes are node I and node J, and depot node is node 0. At first, the algorithm starts with constructing a solution where each customer node is visited by a distinct route. Okay, for instance, it starts with such a solution for a three node instance. And the cost of this solution is the cost of this arc plus the cost of this arc plus the cost of this arc plus the cost of this arc. An alternative solution visits both of these customers on the same route. And this solution has a cost of this arc plus this arc, plus this arc. That means in order to obtain this solution, from this solution, actually we eliminate these two arcs and we add this arc. So the savings associated by obtaining this new solution is the summation of the costs of these arcs minus, since we add this arc as an additional arc, minus the cost of the corresponding arc. To demonstrate how the Clark and Wright heuristic is used to solve a TSP problem, let's consider a simple example. In this simple example, we have a bakery's problem. In this problem, Bridget bakes her bagels during downtime at her brother's bistro. Then she must transport her bagels to two sidewalk concession stands that are run by her sisters. Each stand is located 5 miles from the bistro, but stands themselves are 6 miles apart, as you see in this figure. Clark and Wright starts with constructing an initial solution that originates from depot node, that means from the bistro, that visits the first concession point and then returns back to the depot, and then again originates from depot and visits the second concession point and returns back to the depot. And after that, the savings associated with deleting these two arcs from the solution and including this arc in the solution should be calculated. And this provides a savings amount of 4. So since the initial solution has a cost of 4 times 5 miles, which is 20, the resulting solution will provide a cost of 20 minus 4, which is 60. Next, let's see a little bit more complicated example. In this example, again, we will concentrate on Bridget's bagel bakery problem. Now, Bridget will serve 4 concession points. The distances between all pairs of nodes are provided on the graph in order to apply Clark and Wright heuristic. In the first step, we should start with a solution where each concession point is visited by a distinct tour. We have this initial solution. In the next step, we should calculate the savings associated with each arc. Since we have a symmetric problem, we can compute a half matrix, savings half matrix. Okay, this is the savings half matrix. In this matrix, as you see, there is no value associated with the row corresponding to node 0. Why? Because we already have an arc corresponding to these cells in the initial solution. Next, let's calculate 2 of the savings values in this matrix, S1, 2, for instance. In order to calculate S1, 2, okay, what should we do? S1, 2 corresponds to the summation of the cost of these 2 arcs minus the cost of this arc. So S1, 2 is 8 plus 50 minus 12. Similarly, for S1, 3, we should exclude these 2 arcs and then we should include this arc in the solution. Okay, so we should exclude, we should remove these 2 arcs and we should include this arc, which has a cost of 9. Okay, 8 plus 8 minus 9. After calculating the savings corresponding to each cell, in order to keep track of the resulting solution at each iteration, in the fourth step, we put the appropriate trip indicator to the cell of each arc in the savings matrix that exists in the resulting solution. For example, if there is a two-way trip on an arc in the solution, then we should put 2 to the cell corresponding to that arc in the savings matrix. And in the fifth step, we identify the cell in the net savings half matrix that contains the maximum net savings. If the maximum net savings occurs in cell ij, for instance, for this initial solution, the maximum savings occurs in this cell, cell 2, 3. Then we should check the following 3 conditions. The first condition states that T0i and T0j, that means the corresponding trip indicators, must be greater than 0. Let's check whether this occurs for 2, 3. T02 and T03 should be greater than 0. Both of them are 2 for this initial solution. So this condition is satisfied. And these locations shouldn't be on the same route. Okay, for 2, 3, are these nodes in the same route? No, they are in the different routes. So this is also satisfied. And this third condition is not related to TSP actually. It is related to VRP, and we will see this when we are visiting this algorithm in VRP. As I told, the largest savings comes from cell 2, 3. The first condition is satisfied. The second condition is satisfied. So we can eliminate these 2 arcs and we can include this new arc in the solution. By this way, we can obtain that much savings. After that, we should update these trip indicators so that it represents the current solution. So between 0 and 2 right now, we have one-way arc in the solution. Between 0 and 3, we have one-way arc, and we should have 1 here. We should continue with the next largest savings. Let's check these conditions. T02 and T04 are all greater than 0. So the first condition is satisfied. And node 2 and node 4 are not on the same route. So the second condition is also satisfied. And we are not dealing with the third condition in TSP. So we can include this arc in the solution. How can we do that? After visiting 4, we can visit 2 and then 3 and then 0. So that we exclude these two arcs. And we will obtain a savings amount of 14. Now, let's update the trip indicators. Now, there is no arc between node 0 and node 2, right? It should be 0. Now, we have only one arc between 0 and 4. And we will have one arc between 2 and 4. The next largest savings comes from cell 1-2. Let's check the first condition. T01 and T02 should be greater than 0. However, T02 is not greater than 0, so we cannot consider that. The next largest savings comes from 3-4. T03 and T04 should be greater than 0. Okay, is this satisfied? Yes, both of them are greater than 0. It is satisfied. However, 3 and 4 are on the same route, so it is not satisfied. So we should continue with the next largest saving. It is 1-3. Okay, T01 and T03 are all greater than 0. The first condition is satisfied. 1 and 3 are not on the same route, so both of the conditions are satisfied. That means we can exclude these arcs and we can include this arc in the solution so that we can obtain a savings of 7 units. So the resulting solution starts from node 0, then visits node 4, then visits node 2, then visits node 3, and then 1, and then returns back to depot. This is the resulting solution. The stopping condition for Clark and Wright algorithm is that if we do not have any cell that satisfies these conditions, or if all nodes are visited in just one tour, then we can stop at that point, as we have done in this example.